afternoon, a very warm welcome to the McAlpine Stadium for the final match of the season in the first division of the Nationwide League. Port Vale, the visitors, and for the men from the Potteries, it really is the day when they could stay up or drop into Division 2. So the great escape, that's what it's all about for them. For Town, of course, just the final game of the season, nothing resting on it apart from pride. And of course, the desire to go out on a winning note here in front of the home fans. A warm welcome to our match sponsors this afternoon, the elite fish and chip takeaways and restaurants from Lincoln, and to the club's main sponsor, Panasonic, the official kit supplier of Huddersfield Town Pony, and of course, our match ball sponsors this afternoon, the Huddersfield News Agents. Let's look at the two teams then. In Town, they have Andy Morrison on the bench this afternoon. No Kevin Gray, he's been playing with a broken foot, but had gone through the pain barrier for a couple of games and dropped out last week at Portsmouth when everything was safe. So he's had his operation on his foot. A hernia problem rules out Rob Edwards from the number three shirt, and Wayne Allison has a knee problem, so he too has to sit out this afternoon. That means the Town's lineup in goal, Steve Harper. Two, the Irishman Thomas Heary. David Phillips swaps to number three. John Dyson at four. Five, the informed Sam Collins. Lee Richardson switches to number six. Ian Lawson, he replaces Simon Baldry, the number seven shirt. Baldry left out this afternoon. Barry Horn retains the armband of the skipper at number eight. Marcus Stewart, nine. Paul Barnes, ten. And Grant Johnson was 11 on the bench this afternoon. Andy Morrison at 12, Delroy Facy at 13, Darren Edmondson at number 14. As I say, for Port Vale, this is the culmination of a poor season for the men from Vale Park. They simply have to win. That will be good enough. Anything else, it would be in the lap of the gods. Right up to the final game, Manchester City against Stoke a little later in the afternoon. So we go, Port Vale, for Russell White, two, Matthew Callagher, three, Alan Tankard, Ian Bogieworth, four, Dean Glover, the skipper at five, Dave Barnett at six, Gareth Aikworth, Worth seven, Stuart Talbot eight, Lee Mills at nine, Martin Foyle at ten, and Jan Janssen at number 11 on the bench. To come on if needed, Tony Naylor, he scored a few important goals in his time at Port Vale. Wayne Porter at 13, Andy Porter at number 14. The officials this afternoon is Fraser Stretton, the referee of West Bridgford in Nottingham, and the two assistants, Mr. B. Bello with the yellow flag, and Mr. Ed Carrington with the red flag. And our two mascots for Town this afternoon, an important afternoon for the two youngsters. They are Michael Ladlow and Neil Moore. Michael's 9 years old and attends Rothbard Junior School. Neil is 11 years old and he attends West Vale Primary School. So, as I say, an important match for both these clubs. In many ways, for vastly differing reasons, but Town will want to go out on a winning note, while Port Vale, well, they simply have to win. No choice for them in their plight. And although they're not in the bottom three, they're two above that. If Stoke were to win, Port were to win or draw, Port Vale were to lose, that would dump Port Vale in the bottom three, something, well, they don't even want to think about around the Potteries. So John Rudge, the most important match, I would say, of his managerial career. It's been long, it's been glorious at times, and he won't want to remember a season like this. Certainly I doubt they will ever get in this problem again. He won't allow it, but it's been tough. And in the end, the piper has to be paid, and that means going down. I think it's so be it. But Town, they've had a good season, 10th bottom, and it didn't look at one point when the management team here, Peter Jackson, Terry Allen, took over, as though it would all end happily. But Town have done so very, very well since they came here, and that run of results, that big spurt they put on from March onwards, really was a platform that made sure that they went on to consolidate their place in the first division of the Nationwide League. And there's going to be some big games here again next season, of course. Perhaps amongst them Everton, who knows? Everton and Arsenal later this afternoon, as Arsenal look to wrap up the Premiership at home. it would dump Everton into the bottom three, where they are now. Also, they dropped there, courtesy of Bolton's win yesterday, and it would keep them there. And then they simply would have to win at home against Coventry City next Saturday. Given the way Coventry have been playing this season, well, that would be a very difficult ask of Howard Kendall and his team. So Port Vale in their normal yellow and black quarters, yellow shorts and yellow and black socks. And there are one or two players out there who are more than familiar to me. Down the years, Ian Bogey, lad from the North East, who played at Preston North End. And Gareth Ainsworth, who also did a spell at North End, but he came to Port Vale via Lincoln. He followed his Preston North End manager, John Beck, to Simsall Bank. But Ian Bogey, a fair player on his day. Played with Paul Gascoigne in the youth squad up at Newcastle. He's been at Millwall and Orient as well before moving to Vale Park. So we're underway, the final match of the season. The ball fed out to the far side. Tom Heary having himself in a bit of a muddle. But, well, still hasn't cleared the ball, should have done. Gets it away now. The town, of course, relaxed. And then go about their business. That was a very good win of the ball there from the number 7, Ainsworth. Good player, tricky midfielder, plays wide on the right. Ian Bogey plays in the middle of the park in midfield. Jan Janssen plays it forward towards Martin Foyle. Foyle goes inside, but here he just gets back, flips the ball away. We need to take the sting out of the Vale attacks in the first 10 minutes, quarter of an hour. And then perhaps set things up. Jan Janssen then, he's going to have a shot. He's running across the edge of the area, it comes back, the cross comes in, good header away, David Phillips, who has to cross from right to left to cover for Rob Edwards' absence, and Harper, don't throw that, Fraser Stretton said no, yeah, it was a header intended to be a back pass to the keeper, to feed, although Harper grabbed it, it had crossed the line, said the official, Mr. Carrington, and Fraser Strickland's the corner on the far side, which Jan Janssen will take. He'll look to swing this out round about the penalty spot. There's three in the 6-yard box for Vale, three coming into the deeper position. Round about the edge of the 6-yard box, cleared by John Dyson, but it goes back out to Jan Janssen on the far side. Important moment sees for town because they let Vale get their noses in. Ooh, and that's a goal! They've scored! Well, Martin Foyle has done it, the number 10. Former Southampton player, and one of them scored it. Well, what, 2 minutes? So, 2 minutes, Martin Foyle scores, and that is a blow. So it's 2 minutes, 1 minute 55, we won't argue for a few seconds. And Martin Foyle does the trick. The Vale fans have taken over the South Stand. Absolutely jubilant, but Town only have themselves to blame. Only half cleared the ball, it came back to Jan Janssen, delivered it in. And all of a sudden, used to play for Sweden, of course, Jan Janssen. Came on loan from SK Norrköping a couple of years ago. And cost them in the end £150,000, but that'll be money well spent. Vale will feel that it can stay like this. A long way to go, but nose is in front. That's important early in the match when you've got to win. Brad Johnson, the Scot who hasn't missed a game since arriving here. It'll be one of the success stories of the season. Of course, Town's player of the season isn't known just yet. Can they cross? Yeah, flag up. Mr. Bello far side. Says ball out of play. Town with a makeshift defence in many ways today. Although John Dyson can bring it with Kevin Gray, but I haven't called that makeshift. But Tom Heary playing in the number 2 shirt, David Phillips in the number 3. And I think perhaps that switches to accommodate Gareth Ainsworth. Because it would have given Tom Heary Martin Furlan controls it outside the area, right hand side. Goes down. Corner given. On that 5 minute jet, already Vale with their noses in front that gave them into win. The Vale fans, but there was plenty of them on the M6, they passed me in great numbers, cars, coaches. I expected to see Wallace and Gromit in a sidecar, but I didn't. So I'm not sure Wallace and Gromit are Vale fans, actually. might just rue the fact that they were wasting time when they were one up. You can't do that. It's against the spirit of the game. And they know it. Likes to see teams get relegated, but it's a sad fact of life. Reading are down. Mike Walker's team, Norwich, were there this afternoon, and Mike Walker's lost his job too. Carrow Road, Norwich, hasn't worked out for him the second time round. His contract was terminated this week. Never go back, that's what they say. Good chance now with Marcus Stewart. Don't do much of it. Really telling off where he was going to go there, Stewart. And, didn't really have the answers. Final game for the club this could be. Take on a deal to bring him from Newcastle. He would like to come. Consolidated himself, he's the number one. And, done well while he's been here. Stuart Talbot then spreads the play. Spreads it too much, goal back to once, looks straight out. We've had a quarter of an hour, little more. Port Vale leading him by a single goal. This sun-drenched final Sunday of the season. Coming off the course at the same time. No advantage gained or asked for. Thank you. Port Vale this afternoon, deep lover. Bogey on the run, but two men against him. But that's a good move when Ainsworth crossed it in. There's a flicked header on from Boyle. And then the Jan Janssen coming in from way beyond the far post. I said that's what they did every time. Always two men coming in. And they were, and it felt Janssen. And he just volleyed it in. Stevie Harper without a chance. Ball out of play, and that's a close down. and that they are held differently. The fellow on the near side below me. Here this afternoon, Ronnie Jepson, Rodney Rowe, both played for the respective clubs yesterday, and Ronnie Jepson in fact scored two goals at one hole in their final match at Rundle Park against Grimsby. Nice to see the pair of them this afternoon. We had a yarn before the game. Nice to see Rodney Rowe, such a bubbly character, he's done so well since going to Booth and Crescent. Everyone delighted for him. Thank you. Martin Boyle. Shortly downhill, but down. Birthday to him. He was 35 yesterday, Martin Boyle. So he can pick up his Football League pension from now on, any time he wants to finish playing. Perhaps what was expected of him, but he did a good service. matches. And everyone said to me that it wouldn't be the best of afternoons for Town, given they were safe, and that's the way it's turning out. I know people think that players are overpaid and of the word, but I don't subscribe to that. It's tough out there, 90 minutes. Some weeks twice you've got to do it. Upwards, and then in 24 minutes across from Gareth Ainsworth on the right, flicked on by Foyle, and there was the Swede Jan Janssen coming in from beyond the far post to volley the ball on the angle past Steve Harper. And so Town, I'm sure, will come out in a different frame of mind. I hope so, certainly, add up the pace a little bit. It's not over, although Port Vale are halfway to their goal this afternoon at a half-time score here at the McAlpine Stadium of Town. 0, Port Vale 2. Town, welcome back. As both mascots take the lead for the final time this season. And we're going to see a couple of substitutions. Delroy Tracy, I think, one of them. So, Andy Morrison off, Delroy Tracy off. There are just two that I can see. I'm not sure if active old green subs out on Darren Edmondson as well. Well, Grant Johnson's gone off. Now is Ian Lawson still with us? So we'll let you know as the half progresses, just is missing. But I think perhaps Paul Barnes. Yep, Paul Barnes is off. And Delroy Tracy is coming on up front. Andy Morrison has come on. And Tom Heary's still there, just below me. Just trying to work out who's gone. Grant Johnson and Paul Barnes. So they're the two men off. Midfielder and a forward. Work out. Time, so two's gone. He stayed. I see Andy Morrison back up. full character. Something, they got it, they stayed up. Now Port Vale looking to be going in the same direction. It's never pleasant to send a team down. At least I think players can, well, it doesn't bother them, have a clear conscience. Made no contact. He had to be quick there, Carragher. Horn had got him with his sights on goal. Cross from the left then. Oh, basic! Well, it came to him and it was on the up when he hit it, but he'll perhaps look at it as a chance squandered. It's a good deep cross from the far side, from the left. But the ball was on the up. He had to strike it when he did. He couldn't wait for it as it came in. And the little half volley cleared the bar. Had that gone in, it might have put a whole new complexion on the game. Certainly would have G'd things up. Choice, I promise you that. Well, I said I'd not seen that Peter Jackson on the bench. Sitting there, that is. But now he's in his shirt sleeves over there. Enjoying his afternoon. Afternoon, remember. Delroy Facy to the byline. Good cross, cut it back well. Well, Ian Lawson got there well, but he's had ten eye, a little bit of skew. It was Tom Healy actually. Chased up and done ten eye all over the place. So we're not at quarter to three in the afternoon, that's what I was saying about the sun. Players are not used to bright sunshine in the second half, of course. They often kick off games in the spring months in sunshine, but never finish them in such because of the time. But Cavell again. He pulled it this time. There's a boot missing as well. Little bit as far as Town are concerned. They've had their ears bashed at the interval, no doubt. 1 minute into the half. 56 of the game. Paul Musselwhite grabs it. Stewart with it. Lawson there. Afternoon. I think that's a ploy that I wouldn't disagree with, given that clubs really want all the information they can get on what everyone else is doing, and sometimes just cause problems on the pitch. Well, I don't think we might be getting an update now. No. Not agree who are the sponsors of the on-base scoreline. Logo on the board, but lads, here we go. Harper. Second attempt. Back in it, Town. Delivered well. Yeah, the referee got it right. Could argue. Well, thought they got back in it. Facey's header was a good one. afternoon. Jan Janssen. Well, Harper, you would have to question his positioning. It was from 30 yards out and on an angle. Steve Harper should have done better. So Jan Janssen gets his second of the game. Vale's third on the hour. And that surely makes it safe now for the men from the Potteries. The Vale Park side looking as though they're going to survive in Division 1. But Steve Harper, well, I've got to say, of all the goals he's let in, he hasn't let too many in, of course. It's not like he's been on the wrong end of hidings, but I haven't seen every goal he's let in, but that's the only one that I can vote about here. His position has to be questioned. He's looking skywards now, even. Just after Town thought they were back in it at 2-1, they find themselves down 3-0. Who said it was a funny old game? Andy Morrison. Easy for Russell White. Thank you. October. And so it was going to be an absolute nightmare. Then the management team changed, and the rest, as I say, is history. Brian Horton left. He projects Terry Ellis game. Things started to turn around. That's it, Bournemouth. A little excited there, but otherwise had to stretch slightly to catch that on his line. There's no pace on it, certainly. Say, if you're looking for ways to sum things up, season that when Town only had 4 points and were rock bottom, looked as though it was heading for disaster, but the management team turned it around when they came in. They've built steadily, I'm sure they will in the close season, bring players in. They're looking to strengthen. Of course, they won't want to be in the same problem again next season. Two of the favoured clubs at the beginning of the season, two of them being dropped down, look like going straight back. Perhaps a third via the playoffs, who knows. White out again, a good throw out as well. So here they come again, Stuart Talbot, Lee Mills forward, Martin Foyle forward. They really could do with giving him some help. And Lee Mills, good save by the keeper, Harper. That does it feel he's atoned a little bit for earlier on. And it looks as though that final quarter of an hour. Throw down the line. Dave Barnett gets his head on it. Goes down in a heap. And head injury. Dickens rushes on. It's Jim Lawson who's down. Just marking nobody on the back stick, and it's Lee Glover who Lee Mills, number 9. So Lee Mills gets it, 79 minutes. And header from point blank range. Ian Lawson puts it high into the unmade stand behind the goal. Stand that will be open, of course, come August the 1st here. With the Derby County Premiership side, that's the pipe opener of the season starting on the 8th. Stuart Robson. Stuart Talbot going on. Andy Porter coming on, midfielder for a midfielder. Great attendance for the final day, of course swelled very much by the fact that Vale have got a very big travelling support here for obvious reasons. And, just checking my stats, but I think it's fair to say that it's the biggest defeat of the season at home. That disappoints me, and I tell you what, it'll disappoint Peter Jackson and Terry Evans as well. Vale have worked hard for the win, but not with the 4 goals better. So that's what the final score says. said, it doesn't matter what the rest do. It's in your own hands. It's when it's out of your hands. And that's how City will feel. It's out of theirs. To Port Vale fans, you're going to win 4-0 on the final day, they probably have laughed in your face. It's what a great level of this game of football is. Town's farewell, well, not one to remember, but they all start equal on the first day. It's not the only time everyone is. St. Derby County here from the Premiership on the 1st of August. Here or away, of course, only the fixing computer knows. Andy Morris. So, the final seconds of the 1997-98 season being played out here. Fraser Strett checks his watch. Last August, as I remember, the glory of sunshine, and that's why we had the season here. Well, the good times will be remembered. The string of wins, November, December, and again March, April. It's guaranteed Town would stay in the first division. The memory is very, very vivid still. And great optimism for next season. cleaning up in a second. Indeed he has. Andy Morrison limping, the town skipper. Got to stay on though, no choice. All the substitutes are on, but nothing again. Being told to come off by the manager, but summer's here. Looks like a hamstring pull again. Another problem. One thing that's bedeviled him for throwing strains is hamstrings. Well, we've played 3 minutes now almost. Where this time's come from, but this goal kick will be it, I think. I think the referee's going to collect the ball now, actually. Telling Mr. White. So play it out. I'll blow the whistle, play to the assistant, that's what he's done. And the Vale fans more than happy. It's been a great escape for Port Vale. And Town and their supporters, well, they'll be happy that they made it safe a couple of weeks ago. It hasn't been a glorious finale to the season, but they'll survive. So that's important. Wayne Corden, the reserve keeper, comes up. Braces. And they go up to the fans who have held their line in the stand. The credit to them. John Rudge comes up as well, the manager. It's emotional for John Rudge. He's worked hard to keep them up. The players have been a credit to him this afternoon. Disappointing season for Vale ends in triumph in many ways. Town go off to a standing ovation from the whole faithful, especially from Keelderbank. They'll have Tom Cowan back, hopefully fit and well next season, raring to go. Feel like having a new player and to ball this campaign. The players throw their shirts to the fans. They'll be delighted. They had one booking on the afternoon. And they are happy. Great escape theme, as always. Well, Russell White chucked his shirt in, the keeper. John Rudge hugging his players, thanking them. So an afternoon of high drama. Town already back in the dressing room. 15,610 in the attendance here. And they'll continue to throw souvenirs to the fans. 4-0 the final scoreline after 2 minutes. Martin Coyle. 24 minutes, Jan Janssen, again on the hour, and just for good measure, 11 minutes from time, a header from Lee Mills. So Vale survive. It looks as though their compatriots from the Pottery Stoke are in Division 2, along with Manchester City. On behalf of us all up here on the gantry, another fine season that we've enjoyed. And for me, David Jones, we'll see you again 1st of August.